Hey folks, Dagan here from PMCV UK, and this is going to be a cool little video. In this video, I'm going to let you know 10 of the best amplifier accessories you never knew you wanted. So you've only gone and bought yourself a tasty new amplifier, whether it be a head and a cab, or a combo amp, or even a little practice amp, it doesn't matter. Hey, I'm chuffed for you. Who doesn't enjoy a good new amp day? But there's loads of stuff on the market that people don't realize that's available that simply just helps us get the best out of our amplifier and our overall tone. And in this video, I'll be talking you through them. Some of them might be a little bit obvious, like amp stands and speaker cables. Some of them might not be so obvious, like ABY boxes. And whatever this is, you've got to stick around to find out what this is. But they're all here to help us make our musical lives easier and overall help you. With working in a music store, I see a lot of folk either skimp on certain things or choose the wrong things when it comes to amplifiers. This is a great video to help yourself with your amp, or if you have someone who's just bought an amp or you're buying an amp for a Christmas or birthday, some nice little treats to go with it. One little disclaimer as well, all of these essential amplifier accessories are available at PMT, either your local PMT store or pmtonline.co.uk. When doing the research for this video, I was like, this is going to be really fun, I'm going to help a lot of folk out. The amount of folk which like, oh, you need to buy this really expensive handmade boutique thing, only made in the deepest dungeon in the sea to make your amp sound great. It's, what the hell are you on about? These are all the obvious ones that are awesome and you might not know about. The first thing is an amplifier foot switch. Now you'd be surprised with the amount of amplifiers out there which have multiple channels or you can turn on effects like tremolos and reverbs that don't come with a foot switch. They might have done way back when, but they don't now. They're always an optional extra. An optional extra which are very, very crucial. But the one thing people don't realize is the fact that they all kind of work universally. It's essentially an on-off switch, a latching on-off switch. And my favorite one is the orange FS1. Now, this is solely because it's absolutely bulletproof. This thing weighs a lot, it's super sturdy, and there's a light on it as well. So you know what channel you're on. A lot of orange amplifiers don't come with a foot switch. Obviously, it's separate. You can either get the single one or the dual one, the big FS2. But this is my favorite. One cable to whichever part of the amplifier you want to change. Like on the back of orange, it says channel or reverb. On the back of Black Stars, there's multiple outputs as well as Marshalls and the rest. But all the foot switches do kind of do the same thing. Move one switch to another thing, whether that be choosing channel, between channels one and two, and turning reverbs and all that kind of stuff off. Effects loops on and off. Any foot switch will do, and the orange FS1 is my favorite. A lot of brands make their own foot switches, like Marshall and Blackstar and stuff, or you can use something like the Boss FS5L latching foot switch, not the unlatching foot switch, to change the channels. A bit more discreet, but the FS1 by Orange is bulletproof. Now, next up, we have something quite crucial, I believe, in the current climate of sound guys hating musicians and turning their amp up, and it's an amp stand. Pretty simple, these Attenuators amp stands. This is the TTS Amp 5, I believe. And it's essentially a stand in which you put your amp and it angles it up to you so you can hear it more clearly. Whether that be in the house, they're also great to point at as well. Either in the house, so you're listening to the amp coming through the speakers, because when it's hitting your shins, you can't get the high end as when it's hitting your face. Or on stage, so it properly goes at you and you haven't got to turn it up too much, upsetting the sound guys. What I really enjoy as well is how discreet they are. How discreet? How easily portable they are. They come in three parts, the two bits which actually hold your amplifier, and the bottom of the stand itself. It's as simple as this, okay? Open, boom, pop it on there. These lovely little guys have padding on as well, so you're not going to damage your fantastic amplifier. Pop it in. And there we are, as simple as that, the amp sits on there. There's the little screws at the side which go into holes so nothing's getting moved. And there's even a little safety latch underneath so nothing's going to fall. The amp's not going to tip back on itself. These things are fantastic and very inexpensive. You'll be surprised the tonal difference to when you're hearing an amp stood next to it and it's either hitting the back of your knees or the front of your knees if you're practicing in the house, to when it's actually facing you and you're getting the full whack of your amplifier. Whether that be a combo or a cabinet, these things are immensely handy. It's also much safer than precariously balancing your amplifier on a wall behind it or a pile of books or on a drum tech. And last time I checked, you couldn't hear through your knees, so it needs to be facing you, doesn't it? Next up is a pretty obvious one, which isn't really to do with an amplifier, and that is essentially just to get yourself new cables. You have no idea, working in a music store, the amount of people which are like, oh man, my tone sucks, what's going on with this really expensive amp and this fancy guitar? What's going on? Why isn't the top end there? Find out the cables they're using are like 40 years old and half broken. You need to get yourself some good cables. Now, it's not the way it used to be as well. Even 5-10 years ago, you had to pay a lot of money to get like premium quality cables, the same cables that John Mayer and Eric Clapton use. That's not the case anymore. Technology's advanced so much where you can get great cheap quality cables, cheap cables that are excellent quality. Like these guys, the ones I always use in these videos. Tuatec, I like the right angle ones. These are nitric connectors, which are some of the best connectors on the planet and keep your tone sounding very pure. If you want to be flashy though, I recommend using something like the Fender Coily cables, just because it's Brian May in a nutshell and very 70s, very 80s, Led Zeppelin, Jimmy Page kind of vibe. And these guys will help you maintain your guitar tone when it hits your amplifier. Again, the amount of folk I see with custom shop strats and beautiful Bognor stacks and stuff. And the cables they're using are crap. Like literally, you haven't got to spend that much more. Don't skimp on the cable. If you want good tone, get good cables like the Tuatec ones and the Coily Fender ones. One thing you really need to be aware of as well with cables is to make sure you have enough good quality cables. So if you're buying your first amp with an effects loop in, because you want to have things in the effects loop, but you still want to turn them off on the floor in front of you, you need two more cables to go from the effects loop send into your delay modulation pedals, then back to the amplifier. If you've got a pedal in between it, you need another big cable to go between the pedal, the amplifier, and your guitar. Make sure you've got enough good quality cables. Coming up next, we have something very, very cool, which sounds like you won't use it until you actually get one and have some fun with it, because I didn't realize how cool this could be and how cheap it could be until you actually get your hands on one and have a little fiddle with it. And that is essentially to get an AB switch. Now, I might be jumping the gun here in thinking that you might have two or more amplifiers. You will often find with some big musicians out there, from Joe Bonamassa to Steve Ray Vaughan to Mark Tremonti, they run a couple of different amplifiers, either clean sound and distortion sound. So the clean sound, they might have a couple of lovely Fenders on stage. Distortion sound might have some Mesa Boogies or some Marshalls. So instead of having the clean channel on the Marshalls, they'll actually switch to a different amp to get that clean sound. And obviously that's the most intense, extreme use of an ABY switcher. Oh yes, I'll just casually swap between my vintage deluxe reverbs and my, again, my Bognor stack. Have you ever actually played with one, like in the house, with two amplifiers? I have a Marshall MG15 in the house, a little clean amp, and a bigger Marshall. And sometimes it's fun to just play between them, especially when you get an ABY switch, you can have them running at the same time. You'll often find this with other bands, other big bands, that blend two amp sounds together. That's all well and good when you've got loads of money and the stacks behind you, but it's literally so much fun and you can find some very cool, unique sounds mixing any two amps, whether it be a little miniature Marshall with a big Marshall or a Fender amp and a dirty and a orange amp or everything in between. Mixing two amps together will certainly help you find your own sound. When you buy things like the Boss AB2 and other Boss line selectors and stuff where you can run two amps at once or switch between them, you will have so much fun and discover things you never thought were possible. Also, keep in mind that ABY switches can run from very cheap and awesome to very expensive and awesome. The expensive ones, like the radial ones, can have ground lifts in and special little phasing options, which are super handy if you need it, but sometimes it's very expensive and intimidating. So don't get put off if you Google amp switches and see the expensive ones. Literally talk to us at PMT and we'll get the right one for you. And these switches go by many different names: ABY switches, amp selectors, line selectors. Call your local PMT store up, talk to us online, or actually rock up in person to try some out, and we'll point you in the right direction. So you've got your amp, you've got your multiple amplifiers, and you're taking them on tour. That's a lot of fun. What do you do to keep them safe? What do you do to keep them clean? Everyone likes a rock and roll looking guitar like Stevie Ray Vaughan's number one, but no one likes a relict amp. It just kind of looks unclean. You need, this isn't a new Fender t-shirt, an amp cover. So many companies out there make specific covers for your amplifier, and they're not an expensive accessory to have. You can go full hog and get a big flight case with wheels on to keep your amp good even in the blitz, but an amp cover is an inexpensive way to keep your amp nice and safe. And amplifiers can be expensive, whether it be a Boss Katana or a deluxe Fender reverb, what this is for. And you want to keep them safe, man. We spent our hard-earned money on these amplifiers and they need to be kept safe, because you don't want anything spilling onto them or knocking them, because that can damage something precious. And this is the best way, best inexpensive way to keep your amp nice and safe and clean. It also stops people messing with your settings as well. Once there's a cover on an amplifier, your mates or any jealous guitarists can't mess with your settings, and you can keep them nice and safe for you. They're also very good to point at with when you've got them folded up. Now, next up, we have the, I'm going to call it the little white elephant of the room. And I'm not talking about the trunk on this Kramer 84. I'm talking about this. This is a little box which has changed my guitar playing life. This is a two-note Torpedo Captor X. Now that's a lot of words, and people don't know what that means. I've got a full review of that on our channel. Essentially, this is the best thing to happen to the guitar amplifier ever. It's absolutely insane. I've got this running. What you heard in the intro, the guitar playing, this stuff. To get the best sound out of an amplifier, especially a valve amplifier, you have to crank it up so it's ear-piercingly loud. I've got this Black Star up so loud, but it's nice and quiet in volume. That's because I'm running the Black Star into this. That is not only what this does. This takes this does so much, okay? It's an attenuator, so that attenuates the sound, so it brings the overall volume down to make it a manageable level, and then pumps it through the speaker. But I'm not running it through the speaker. There's no microphones on this cabinet. There's XLR output on the back of this, and I've got it going straight to that little zoom thingy going into your lovely ears, and I've got a PA speaker on the floor right now. And within that, you can pick from vintage amplifiers, modern amplifiers, multiple amplifiers. You can mic it wherever you want, all totally digitally and through an app on the phone, as well as upload your own IRs to it. So impulse responses of your favorite amplifiers and cabinets, but I've never felt the need to do that because the ones that come with the Two Notes software is utterly phenomenal. You can tweak it on the front, you can control it by MIDI, you can have a 1x10, a 2x10, a 6x10, vintage microphones, modern microphones, all in one little box. And I've got the amp running on like an ear-shattering volume coming through a PA speaker in front of me. It's one of the best things in the world for practicing at home in silence, because you can run a vintage Marshall into this, for gigging, because you haven't got to mic anything up and you can have your sounds repeated night after night because it's all digitally in this little box. There's also effects built in, there's reverb, so if your amp hasn't got reverb, like, you can literally run a Marshall Super Lead from 1986 into this without a cabinet, because if you plugged an amplifier head from the speaker output into a mixing desk, the amp would explode and your head would explode. And yeah, your head might explode, the interface will explode. You can run a vintage Marshall into this, put your headphones on and have it so quiet it wouldn't even wake a baby. This thing is one of the best things to happen to the guitar world in a very long time, and check out my full review at PMTV UK. Speaking of blowing up expensive amplifiers and even inexpensive amplifiers, because you can use the Two Notes with any amp, combo, head, as long as there's a speaker line out, you don't want to blow up your head or amplifier by using a guitar cable to hook it from the head to the cab. Guitar cables aren't designed, even though they look exactly the same as speaker cables, to take that level of input, like 100 watts going through a guitar cable, which is designed to go to an overdrive from your guitar, will just be very bad for the head. So, like I was saying earlier, with regular cables being great quality now compared to what they were 5 years ago, even 10 years ago, Tuatech makes some fantastic speaker cables. These are cables specifically designed from going from heads or amplifiers, different like combo amplifiers, to separate cabinets. They can handle the huge wattage and your amp's gonna be nice and safe. And these Tuatech ones have Neutra connectors, very, very good, but totally inexpensive. So I can't stress enough, don't use a guitar cable. Even some of the cables which come with amplifiers to hook up between the head and the cab aren't very suitable. Always ask a member of PMT staff if you need a speaker cable or not. And if people are commenting down below saying, I've used a guitar cable for years, you don't need to spend £6 on a speaker cable for the impedance. You're very lucky, and hats off to you. Hope you have a fantastic day. But one day, your lovely amplifier will go bang because you didn't spend the extra money and get a specific speaker cable instead of an instrument cable. Now, next up is a little accessory and tip that I thought kind of only I did, because it was the only thing which managed to work at the time, till I realized a few people do it, and it's a fantastic thing to have in your signal chain for the amplifier, and that is a volume pedal. Now, people see volume pedals of all shapes and sizes, these massive 500 ones, so it fits like my massive size 12 feet, or the smaller ones, which are totally pedalboard friendly. You just assume these are for either killing the signal or doing like funky volume swells like your Peter Frampton. What I use them for is because my old amp was just a single channel, like a dirty amplifier, and to get a clean sound, you had to roll the volume back on your guitar, like the old school way of doing it. I'm awfully handsy when it comes to playing guitar, and if I'm rocking out, I don't want to be going for the volume because I might miss it, all that kind of stuff. With some Boss pedals, this one especially, which is this, the FV500H, the high impedance one, there's a little controller on the side. So if you want a clean sound of a single channel amplifier and you don't want to awkwardly stop playing and take your hands away from the fretboard to turn the volume control down, where you might actually get to the wrong sweet spot almost, because like 2 or 3 is a really nice, sweet, clean sound on a distorted amplifier, there's a little control on the bottom which actually sets the minimum volume. So when this is at 0, it could be around 2 or 3, so some signal is still coming through it, and you can get a beautiful clean sound while still playing guitar. Gradually bring it in with your foot and gradually bring it back. Volume pedals are great fun for the amplifier, which only has one channel. Obviously, you can also use it to do volume swells and kill the sound completely, or put it in the effects loop for like a solo boost almost. Because when you have it in the front of the amp, it's hitting the preamp, literally making the signal hotter or weaker, dirtier or clean if you're on a dirty channel. When you have it in the effects loop, it's bypassing the preamp, so it's actually just the volume itself. So you can set this to like 8, okay? And have the lovely distortion sound of the preamp of your amplifier. 8, it's all the way back. And you're literally only bringing in 2 of whatever this is, 2 notches of volume for a solo sound. So instead of having a boost, you can have one of these set all the way back and have the minimum volume set to 8 in the effects loop, because it's then affecting the power amp, not the preamp, because the effects loop comes after the preamp. Knock it at 10 for a solo, bring it back. Just another cool little thing you can do with a volume pedal. Now, the eagle-eyed amongst you might have noticed a slight change to the amplifier setup here on my left. And that is because the next accessory I want to talk about is an obvious one, but there's more layers to it than what you think. And that is guitar cabinets. If you buy a head, like any of these beautiful ones here, the PV6505MH, the EVH5153 Stealth Lunchbox Head, or the big Blackstar HT Stage 100 Mark II, you need a cabinet. Cabinets just house the speakers. These heads house all the electronics and the stuff that actually makes the sound, but they don't work without these. Now, it's obvious if you buy a head, the lovely PMT member of staff will have said you need a cab to go with it if you don't already have one. However, there's more depth to the world of guitar cabinets than what people have realized. Granted, getting a matching cab is all well and good, or if you already have a cabinet, you may want to consider having a bit of fun with a different cabinet, because you could get loads of the same 12-inch speakers, okay? Most of the time you will see 12-inch speakers in 2x12s and 4x12s. If you had a 1x12 and a 4x12 with the same speakers in, the 1x12 will sound totally different to the 4x12. So experiment with these speakers to get the sound that you want. Also, you can mix and match them. 1x12s and smaller speakers are a little bit brighter, a little bit more focused on the mid-range. There's a lot more low-end with the 4x12s. When you mix them together, you get very unique sounds that will kind of help you make your own sound. Plus, no matter what age you are or what skill level on guitar you're at, when you look at lots of amplifiers, it just makes you go, wow. Because it's like, oh, this is AC/DC, or this is Motorhead, or this is Led Zeppelin back in the day with a wall of Marshalls. It makes you giddy when you're a guitar player and you see lots of amplifiers. But there's a big total difference between big cabs and small cabs, like I say, even if they do have the same speakers in, and that's even more so with different size speakers. But I am warning you, don't run like a 100-watt head into a 1x10 speaker cone, because it will just blow up immediately. Make sure the impedances are all there. Check out Sam's video on PMTV UK, where he talks about ohmages and wattages on what speakers work with which amplifier. Now, last but certainly not least, we have a cool new accessory which totally broke ground when it was released, and it's inexpensive as well. I'm not going to take out the little plastic covers because they're all shiny and new. This is the Boss WL20 wireless system, and it's 2 bugs, okay? If you guys are watching this thinking wireless systems have passed, which used to pick up radio systems from cars and police vans outside, they're big, bulky units where you have to have a big thing on top of your amplifier with big aerial sticking out, then a big wireless receiver here. It's all clunky. All the batteries are going to die. It's going to be awful. It's going to pick up radio systems from the local radio station. That's not the case anymore. Not the case anymore at all. This is a receiver and this is a transmitter. One goes in the guitar, one goes in the front of the amplifier, and it's totally digital. So via Wi-Fi, I believe, these things talk to each other, so there's going to be no interference with any signal. But it's the convenience aspect of it just being 2 little bug transmitters which really blows everyone's minds, because it sounds fantastic. Because it's digital and Wi-Fi, the tone is so clear. In some cases, they've had to put like cable buffers in to give you more of a cable sound because it was so precise and so clear. These things sound fantastic, and it's the discreteness and the way in which they charge. There's no batteries. These are charged via USB. You plug them into each other, then plug them into the wall, and you get hours and hours of playing from not a lot of charge. Great for in the house, you're not tripping over cables on your living room floor, and great for the stage where you can do guitar spins way into the night. So I think that's it, ladies and gents. 10 of the best essential amplifier accessories that you didn't know you wanted. Some of them are obvious, and hopefully I've got my point across with the fact that you need decent cables and don't use an instrument cable instead of a speaker cable, because things will go boom and ruin your day. Some less so obvious, like the 2/0 torpedo wherever I've put it, and using a volume pedal to get a clean sound, as well as that amazing WL10 wireless by the fine folk at Boss. Plus, it's Boss, so you know it's going to outlive all of us as well. All of these things are available at pmtonline.co.uk, so please check them out on the page. There's also a fantastic blog post explaining what everything does in a bit more detail if you're tired of listening to my daft Geordie accent. And as always, that's been a lot of fun. I am here to help, and if you want to comment down below any other accessories people should buy, please do, because I love learning about this stuff just as much as you guys do. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any of the products I've spoke about here today, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this amazing amp stack but with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.